Welcome back. Today the text is from Gospel of Luke chapter 1 verses 6 and 7. Let me read out this text for you. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. So Mary gave birth to her firstborn son. What does that mean? Does it mean that Mary had one or more children after Jesus? Because the term firstborn is used here. Does it mean that Mary was not perpetually virgin and that she had normal relationship with Joseph? What can we conclude from this term, the firstborn? Let us look at the text and see what it means. Now, to interpret this text that Mary had other children after Jesus is to misinterpret the way in which the ancient Jews used the term firstborn. For them, the firstborn referred to the child that first opened the womb and was to be consecrated to the Lord. Let me read out to you Exodus chapter 13 verses 1 and 2. The Lord said to Moses, "Consecrate to me all the firstborn, whatever is the first to open the womb among the Israelites of human beings and animal is mine." So under the Mosaic law, it was a firstborn son that was to be redeemed. Being a firstborn in the Semitic society, it means conferring a special privilege, a special right to the firstborn. And it did not necessarily mean that there is a children after the firstborn. The firstborn, therefore, simply means the first to be born, that is, the one before whom nobody else had been born. In Exodus chapter 13, verse 1 and 2, when God tells Moses to consecrate the firstborn, Moses did not have to wait for the secondborn to be born to realize that the firstborn was the first, and then consecrate him to the Lord. Further, it is worthwhile to notice that in the divine nature, Christ is firstborn of the Father. Read Hebrews 1:6. Let me read out to you Hebrews 1:6. When the Father brings the firstborn into the world, he says that all the angels of God worship him, and yet he is the only son. And so the church in the Catechism of the Catholic Church says this: Jesus is Mary's only son, but her spiritual mother would extend to all men whom indeed he came to save. The son whom she brought forth is he whom God placed as the firstborn among many brethren, that is, the faithful in whose generation and formulation she cooperates with her mother's love. In conclusion, we say that Jesus is called the firstborn. That does not necessarily mean that Mary had other children after Jesus. Jesus is given this title of firstborn to indicate not only that Mary gave birth to no other child before him, but also because it is a title of honor, as explained earlier. And so Jesus, who is the firstborn, is the only Son of God the Father and only son of Mary. Let's now say the Novena prayers together. O Blessed Virgin Mary, our dear Mother, we rejoice at God's special favor bestowed on you in choosing you to be the Mother of His Divine Son. With deep faith, you willingly said yes to the angel Gabriel and brought forth Jesus our Savior into the world. With extraordinary care, courage, and commitment, you fulfilled your responsibilities as a devoted mother and a worthy handmaid of the Lord. O dear Mother, we rejoice as we look forward to the celebration of your birthday. What better gift can we offer you, O Mary, on your birthday than by wholeheartedly living as you live in total devotion to Jesus, your Son. May we ever keep Him at the center of our lives, the source of inspiration for the members of our families and our parish. Please mention your needs. Together, pray for us, O Mary, to your Son, Jesus, and help us to live Christ-centered lives at the service of others. Thus, may our lives truly manifest the love of God, our Father, as we strive through the power of the Holy Spirit to bear witness to His kingdom in our midst. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The Lord be with you. Through the intercession of Mary, our loving Mother, may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you.